I think by June, we may look back at this left-handed slam that iced this game. It might just be the play of the year in the National Basketball Association. Yet, that outrageously spectacular left-handed slam was exactly why Kevin Durant is no longer Russell Westbrook's teammate. This is exactly the kind of Russell Westbrook solo mission that drove Kevin Durant crazy.
Hey guys, it's BHB, and today we'll be looking at a basketball game played nearly 5 years ago. It's November 16, 2016, and the Houston Rockets have gone to the Chesapeake Arena to take on Russell Westbrook and the Oklahoma City Thunder, who recently lost Kevin Durant to the offseason the summer before to the vaunted Golden State Warriors. Russell Westbrook so far in the season has posted these numbers in the 11 games having played. In the end, the only thing that seems to possibly be able to stop him is Russell Westbrook himself. But let's get back to the game. Houston and the Thunder are intertwined score-wise for most of the game, and as we're near the end, we find OKC is up with 3 with 7.1 seconds left to go in the game. Alex Abrines is having a difficult time inbounding the ball until Russell gets free of his man, sprints baseline, catches the ball, and well, this really just happens.
One remaining. Westbrook shows from the basketball, goes to the rim! And sticks the dagger into the rock!
Now let's be honest here, that was a spectacular dunk. Russell Westbrook to reach 30 points for the night absolutely posterizes an elite rim protector in Clint Capella, who would average 2 blocks just the next season. The crowd goes wild, the Thunder win the game, and Russell Westbrook is once again the undisputed hero. But there's just one problem. To be fair, that was probably one of the worst decisions that Russell Westbrook could have made in that situation. Now many of you are probably already heading down to the comment section telling me to, you know, shut up and admire greatness. But seriously, just look at this again. There's 7.1 seconds left on the clock. Russell Westbrook catches it, and immediately we pause. Up 3, what's the correct basketball play here? Try to dunk it over a 6'10" center to increase the lead to 5 points, risking a block or missed dunk attempt? Or hold the ball, get fouled, and go to the free throw line, where he was 85% all year. If you have a basketball IQ higher than 80 on a scale that goes up to 162, then you will most likely hold that ball and go to the line for your free throws. Also, if you look even closer, Russell Westbrook nearly loses control of the ball, and if he does, the Rockets have a chance to tie with a 3, and with the momentum swinging for Houston, win the game in overtime. Many of us analyze the greatness of the play, but don't acknowledge the thunderstorm of criticism that would have arisen as a result of Russell Westbrook's boneheaded play. However, in the end, this play is simply not just a magnificently risky play by Russell Westbrook, it's career-defining. What goes into this play? 3 things. Athleticism, ignorance, and sheer will. Now let's begin. Athleticism. Let's be honest, that's literally what Russell Westbrook has created his career image off of. His image off the court and on the court has always been emphasized, but what a freak of nature he is. Seriously, his 10th best career dunk is most likely better than your favorite player's best dunk. And whether it be a regular season or playoff game, Russell Westbrook is dunking on someone's head, and it's with authority. And I'm sorry, I just have to add this dunk in particular.
Has it blocked? The 5th block for Serge Ibaka on the floor! Russell Westbrook!
Okay, let me just say this. That is hands down the best dunk I've ever seen. That beats LeBron's poster dunk on Nurkic by a mile. Like, Brody flew through the air and slammed it so hard you heard the rim being racked through the playoff intensity in Chesapeake Arena. You could literally hear his wrist slam against the rim. Like, I don't understand how people don't have this rated as one of the most spectacular dunks of all time. Like, people were screaming about LeBron's dunk. Bro, that Westbrook, nah man, I could be here all day talking about that, so we're not going to. But look, next up we have ignorance. In 2016, there was 2 commercials that I found to be the most ignorant pieces of Russell Westbrook's career, yet they were absolutely hilarious. Firstly, we're gonna show a more serious Westbrook commercial.
Some run, some make runways. From Jordan.
Bruh, in my opinion, it's like dope. but the shots fired here are ridiculous. Some run, some make runways. Like, I understand the anger at KD leaving for Golden State, but no one, especially the Thunder or Russell Westbrook, should be mad that he ran away. He gave them 7 years of his service and was free for the NBA market. Also, I already mentioned it, but the last person that should be mad KD left is Russell Westbrook, because Russ was the main reason KD left. These boneheaded plays at the end of games is the reason why KD had to go. The ignorance of not being able to understand that he himself was the reason for his failure is one of the reasons he hasn't gone past the second round for 4 years. But to lighten the mood, we have one more commercial that still shoots shots, but in just an amazingly hilarious way.
Frank Mueller. Boy, I start on the bottom, huh? Made my way to top. What? Boy, I'm gon' keep winning. No, I cannot stop. I can. Remember, I had a little. Turned that shit to a lot. Always been 100. Put that on my block. Oh, yeah. Used to want that full door. Now I want that drop. Yeah, now I do what I want. What? Now I do what I want. Yeah. 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 Now I do what I want.
Like, bruh, now I do what I want, except, I mean, you really can't get past the second round, but that really ain't none of my business now, is it? Like, I'm sorry, like, I might be coming off hella cynical right now, so we'll just move on to the, I guess, the final part, which is kinda good, kinda bad in Russell Westbrook's career, and that's gonna be sheer will. Okay, there are players like Kobe and Jordan who have an absolute killer mentality. Those guys represent the best of the best. However, when it comes to absolute will to do anything he can in his power, Russell Westbrook, by many people's standards, is at the top. However, many people assume incorrectly that having plenty of will is a positive thing. 99% of the time it is, but you know what they say. Too much of a good thing is a bad thing. And Russell Westbrook has way too much sheer will. Russell Westbrook literally wants to win so badly, he puts his teammates to the side as a result. This has been shown multiple times throughout the year. The incessant need for triple doubles, the ridiculous need to average a triple double, and most importantly, the low IQ basketball plays in the playoffs that can only be the result of blind hunger. Whether it be ignoring KD at the end of games, all those times during the most crucial moments, or taking an ill-advised shot at the end of a basketball game, Russell has always let his hunger to win ironically prevent him from winning. One of the most painful moments to watch from his career is the 2018 NBA playoffs against Utah Jazz in the first round of the NBA playoffs. After a game 3 loss against the Jazz, the Thunder, with their big 3 of Westbrook, Melo, and PG-13, find themselves down 1-2 in the series. When discussing the game 3 loss due to Ricky Rubio's outstanding 26-point triple-dub, Russell Westbrook declared to the NBA world that he would, I can just show you here.
Especially, I think from mid-range, I think he started 5 for 5. Just what led him to get so hot there?
He made some shots. I'm gonna shut that off next game, though. Guarantee that.
And some chatter afterwards. Rubio goes down, and a foul called. Westbrook just motioned over to Billy Donovan. Don't take me out, Westbrook, and Crowder.
Step back in. Westbrook turns the corner, gives it off to Adams. Too strong. Rebound, Ricky. Utah with the ball. They missed their last 6 shots, and Westbrook just hammers Ricky to the floor. All his points, Matt, from the free throw line. 0 for 2 from the floor.
Well, all his fouls has been on Rubio, trying to just watch over the top here.
It was 14-13 Utah, and the Jazz
that's
up
number
one.
4. That's a huge call. A huge call. 4 fouls now on Westbrook.
To the bench he goes with a minute 36 left in the half.
Rubio, you get an out of control Westbrook. That is certainly the right call. Great, great call in the right zone.
So dude straight up made a claim, and I don't know if y'all watched, but Russell Westbrook backed it up at the expense of his team, as the Jazz beat the Thunder by 17 in the next game and would go on to win the series in 6. I mean, yeah, Ricky Rubio didn't have that great of a game 4, but in the end, it doesn't matter if you're on the couch watching his playoffs from home. So unfortunately, Russell Westbrook's sheer will is an amazing thing to have when defining a legacy, but the actions that come as a result of his need to win will always taint his argument when placing Russ against the other great point guards. In the end, Russell Westbrook is already a top 10 NBA point guard of all time at the relatively young age of 32, and regardless of his boneheaded, low IQ, ignorant basketball plays at the most crucial of times, he represents the best qualities that make an NBA player. If you take anything away from this video, just know that Russell Westbrook, even though he might not be a winner, he is one of the most spectacular NBA players that we have seen in the past 10 years, and maybe for the following 10 as well. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed, and if you guys have any debates or arguments to leave on the table, be sure to let me hear it from the comment section down below. Y'all have a great day, and goodbye.
Take out the red tonight. Put your arms around me, baby. Hi.